I'm Andrzej Mazur, and I will be talking about the evolution of HTML5 games. I'm going to start with the year 2011, which was pretty important, because the W3C workshop at the On Game Store conference happened, and the future of HTML5 games was discussed there. I was attending that. And like a few months later, I was giving a talk called "Is HTML5 Ready for Gaming?" Which kind of was, but not exactly. We had some issues building web games, we had poor performance, audio was crappy or not working at all, so basically developers were creating games without audio. Some developers were trying to make them work offline, but failed miserably. And most of the APIs back then were kind of super experimental and didn't work either, anyway. The good news are, this all works. We can build stuff, we can build games with those technologies. The performance improved, we can have a full 3D experience right in the browser with 60 frames per second. We can play audio, we can also create audio with online editors. We can also play guitar on stage with web audio, which is really awesome. We can create web applications and games with progressive web apps, which will make them work offline. And the API support is really great, so we don't have to worry about the APIs not working because reasons. So the current state of play kind of look nice. The technology is sufficient, but we have some issues that arose after that. So we have discoverability issues and lack of monetization options. So discoverability. Back in 2011, you could create an HTML5 game, publish it, and basically that's it. You could end up in articles like 30 best HTML5 games, because basically there was literally 30 games total around the world. So it was pretty easy. Now, the market totally changed, and basically you can have, there are hundreds of developers creating hundreds of games, so it's really, really hard to stand out. Monetization is also an issue. The focus from licensing games, where you just sell license, give a source code, and it works, and you get paid, are long gone. Now, most of the deals are based on revenue share, dealing with adverts, which deals with privacy and all that stuff, which is kind of not perfect, I would say, the least. But I think the future is bright. There was a second W3C workshop about the future of games, of web games, held a few months ago, where the future was discussed. And it had some interesting outcome. So I think we have, the technology is good enough, we can use various APIs and technologies to build cool stuff. And I think the key will be to mixing some ingredients. So I can totally imagine building a hyper-casual game, a 2D game which will use offline capabilities from the progressive web apps. If you take the game and put it in a VR, it could change to a VR game. Maybe it will be 2D in the 3D space and have some 3D effects or something like that. You can speed it up with web GPU and with WebAssembly, because why not? Discoverability is also improving after the workshop. The W3C was discussing using schema.org to have to extend some schemas to inform search engines about some features of the games or some basic information. So then that information could be used, and for example, HTML5 games could be presented in search engines in a way the videos are. So for example, a GIF or video or like basic information about how the game is earning money or what is the category, etc., etc. And interestingly enough, after that workshop, we started discussions about the monetization, And there is something called Web Monetization API, which is a proposal for an open standard, which works in a way that you inform the browser that your website is monetized by adding a meta tag to a site, pointing at a wallet, and basically that's it. Your site is web monetized. And the cool thing is you get paid real time, instantly, so you are earning money, you don't have to wait months for reports from publishers. And this is great because we don't have to use the advertisements, we can skip all that crap, no issues with privacy, spying, selling data, etc., etc. Just direct payments to the wallets. And there is a Grant for the Web fund, which is going to give $100 million in the span of 5 years to the content creators on the web that want to create anything and try web monetization in their business plans. So it doesn't have to be games, it can be websites or podcasts, videos or whatever. So to summarize, the technology is sufficient, we can always improve it. We can play with it, we have most of the ingredients. The discoverability problems can be overcome with better indexing and better showing the results. And monetization issues might be fixed with the new web monetization API. So I encourage you to try all that and build the future of the web. Thank you.